Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to Mulroy Bay, where today I haven't thought anything through at all. Now, what we need to do is we need to get some money together because I want to fertilize my fields. Now, I say fields plural because we got field 11 seeded in canola. We have field 26, which is down by the shop. Seeded in wheat, I think. What have I seeded? I can't remember what I seeded where. barley, even. 11 is in canola. 26 is in barley. And if you see here, there's a teeny tiny little field over here. And I can bring you to it, because it is just here. This is our sugar beet field for the pigs and the cows. And we're going to kind of keep that as sugar beet for the foreseeable future. What I'm going to do is kind of make a plan as I go, because I know what I want to do this episode, but I have no way of doing it. I want to start, I want to get some fertilizing done. So what I think the best thing to do is to get, to get rid of the Hurleyman, because this is the least powerful tractor I have, and I'm just not finding any use for it whatsoever. So this is going to go. Ironically, the Hurleyman would be more than capable of using the fertilizer spreader I'm going to get, but that's kind of beside the point. I think sell point is up here. Where's the sell trigger? Yeah, it is up here. So we're going to get rid of this. Oops. Get rid of that. We're going to buy in fertilizer spreaders. I'm going to buy in the Cavernland Exacta EL700 from the Gold Edition DLC. What else do I want to do? I need to get a different tractor now. You are in a good position. Just going to reverse. Shoot forward, not this hill. So, sorry I got a bit of a frog in my throat. I've just had a bite to eat. Normally I record on Saturday afternoons. I record today's video on a Saturday afternoon, record Wednesday's video on a Saturday afternoon. But, I didn't sleep last night, which always ends well. Look at my Donesque video from last week, and you'll see why. I didn't sleep last night, and it's something like 8 o'clock in the morning. So, yeah, recording this a lot earlier than usual. Gonna get a good day out of it. Hoping to get all of this week's videos done today. Excluding Donesque, you might well get 2 videos at Donesque. Although, if... I don't know. I might release the first one the same time as this, or pretty soon thereafter, because I did get a lot of work on Donesque done overnight. Got a lot done while waiting for Gold Edition to finally release, because thank you Steam, you are douchebags. So yeah, Donesque has had a lot of progress, and I really do mean a lot. I've got some learning to do before I can really proceed much further. I need to remember where on earth the fertilizer trigger is up here. I'm not 100% sure. I think it's actually in here. In this building. Yes! So let's refill this. I'm not going to get much into it. It's about 700 litres exactly. Yep. Not the biggest fertilizer spreader in the world, but I don't really need the biggest fertilizer spreader in the world. I need one that's just about big enough for my fields. And this should cover field 11 quite nicely, I think. If I need to refill, so be it. I can refill. So I think this is going to be the first time you guys see any of the Gold Edition stuff in action from me, I guess, because I know I'm not the only YouTuber you guys watch, and I know that, you know, I know that literally every farm sim YouTuber has done a video on Gold Edition, at least one, and I know I was late to the party. That was somewhat intentional. I'm saying this now, I wanted to see what the views would be like compared to a normal map and mod spotlight. Plus I kind of wanted to get my own thoughts together and get everything rendered up and ready. And that really didn't happen until overnight. I only got the videos uploaded overnight for me. So Friday night I got the videos uploaded. That was as quickly as I could have got them up, really. It was like 11 or 12 o'clock Friday night. So yeah, I've been up all night Friday night. Today, it's now Saturday for me. And I spent the night watching Bob Ross on Twitch. And if you don't know who Bob Ross is, good lord, what is wrong with you? He is the world's greatest painter ever, and he has the happiest clouds in the world. Yeah, they gave Bob Ross his own Twitch channel. And I know that he's... If you don't know who Bob Ross is, spoiler alert, he's actually dead. he's been dead for about 20 years. But yeah, I've watched him all night because that is the chillest stuff you can do. You can do literally anything while watching Bob Ross. I decided to do literally every field on Donesk while watching Bob Ross. Or at least listening to Bob Ross. I wasn't particularly paying attention to his paintings or Twitch chat, which, that is the most adorable thing I will ever see, I think, is the Twitch chat reacting to the Bob Ross marathon. Or the Joy of Painting marathon, as it's also known. At the start of every episode, it's "Hi Bob," or "Bob's back," or something like that. And at the end, it's "GG, well played," which is absolutely adorable. And they like legitimately treat it like an esport the entire stream. And chat is insane because there's like 50,000 people in there. It's wonderful. It's one of the nicest things I've seen in a long time. And to be quite honest, if you need to chill out, twitch.tv/Bob Ross, and you will be chilled out. Or if you go onto Bob Ross's YouTube channel, you can also watch or listen to The Joy of Painting. Which, I don't paint. I just listen to his voice. That voice, that wonderful, wonderful, chilled out man. I know I'm not doing the best job of fertilizing here. I don't particularly need to. I just need to get the field covered. I made an absolute hames of that turn. And I'm almost out of fertilizer. Lord, 700 litres isn't much. 700 litres really isn't a lot, is it? Yeah, I should probably say Donesk. I was talking to Pedro. I'm terrible at names. I was talking to Pedro last night about Donesk and my expectations of what I'll end up with. And if you are a big fan of course play, you're gonna be very, very, very annoyed with the map. Oh god, you're going to be very annoyed. I've got all the fields in, they're all pretty much similar to the fields here on Mulroy, but I don't plan on having non-collidable hedges. I plan on using the Bullet Bill school of hedging, I guess. So you'll have hedges with collisions, and courseplay doesn't like hedges with collisions. Yeah. I know that when I finally upload the map, to probably FSUK or something. I am going to get the... If I do it on FSUK, the support topic is immediately going to be, oh my god, why do the hedges have collisions? The answer is, of course, because I want the hedges to have collisions. That's... Never ask a map maker why they do something. Because the answer is always, because I wanted to. But, yeah. I gotta talk about Donegal for a bit, because why not? I'll probably cover this all again in a video specifically about Donegal, but I actually want to cover this in a video that people actually watch. that sounds really bad of me. I want to just cover this in a couple of videos so that the word is out there. And, you know, perhaps if you want to make a map, number one, you should be watching the Donegal series, where I'm actually making a map and talking through the processes I'm using and what's going on. And number two, the best thing you can do when you're making a map is get the Any Sign, Any Size mod from FSUK. Import a sign, pretty much any sign will do. Stretch it so that it fills up the entire map, and use the area that, if you're basing it on a real area, this works like an absolute dream. Get a satellite image from Google Maps of the actual area you're going to use, trace out all the fields, colour them all in, whatever texture you want to use, cultivated, seeded, ploughed, whatever. I think I switched to cultivated because it actually looks nicer from the air. And I'm not going to put in any crops until I got the PDA map sorted. And that's not going to happen for quite a while, because I want to get all the actual models in next and get the map ready for it to be somewhat playable. That's kind of the next big chunk of work that I want to do. Is get it basically functioning, and then add in the scripts. Then the PDA map will go in, then I'll start testing, I guess, and don't quite know how I'm going to test the map. Really don't know how I'm going to test the map. I'm going to be honest. I have no idea what my testing plans are. I do want to do multiplayer testing, so I will most likely be getting my hands on a server for Farm Sim, and other than that, I have no idea. I might run a TeamSpeak, I might just get all the testers added to my own Skype, my own personal Skype, so if I do choose you to test the map, please don't give up me Skype. Because that is my, like, the Skype that I would use is my Skype, unless I set up one specifically for YouTube, which I probably won't. But either way, I will probably do a multiplayer test on a Deddy server. So, you know, the testers can hop in and out, and I can hop in and out. And I will, of course, be making some videos of the testing, which is going to essentially be me getting a bunch of people to try and break the map in any way we possibly can. So, yeah, if you like watching maps get broken, that's going to be fun. I got a kind of a plan in my head of what I want to do during the testing, I just don't have an idea of how I'm going to carry it out. But that's kind of the roadmap for the Donegal series of map making. Is, you know, the fields are now in, I'm going to show you all the fields. I didn't do many videos of doing the fields because, oh my god, that is the most tedious bloody work. It was literally just me sat watching Bob Ross and tracing things. And then untracing them, and then realizing I was using the wrong brush size, and then changing the brush size. And starting over because I was trying to do it over the DEM, and that was a terrible idea. Then backing up the DEM, creating a new flat DEM. Doing it all again, realizing I'd screwed up, starting over again, And finally last night I got to the point where I was quite pleased with the kind of... I'm not going to say they're finished fields. They're not finished fields. And they don't have field boundaries set or anything like that as of yet, because they're not finished, basically. When I declare the fields finished, they will get field boundaries. Until then, they're just going to be cultivated blobs. The fields as they are now are kind of a hot mess, to be honest. The edges are very, very rough in spots. Some of the edges I do need to get rid of or have got rid of already and stuff like that. Yeah, it's just kind of tweaking them now, and I think the final tweaks will come once I got most, if not all, of the models and stuff I want in. And some sort of rudimentary economy set up. Because I have no idea how I'm going to do that yet. It's going to be a very, very, very work-heavy map. Just looking at the field shapes and field sizes. And number of fields, that's... Let me put it this way, it's going to be no... What was that map for 2013? There was a map for 2013, I think it was Canada or something. And it had literally three fields. It was just three massive, massive, massive fields. Which was fine, but... I think I played it for like a couple of days and got really bored of doing one field. Donetsk is... Is that just a tiny spot of grass there? No, it was a spot that I kept missing somehow. Down to field 26 now. This is why I'm talking about Donetsk and doing this, because I don't need to think. I'm not 100% happy with how the fields are right now. There's a lot of tweaking left to do. I do have the river / brook / whatever you want to call it running through the map. I'm going to say that's 90% finalized in terms of everything is there. So really the next step is getting my hands on some models, and I've got some. I don't have all the models I want, and I'm going to go back onto Mod Hoster probably later today and go rooting around for models and stuff like that. And if you're a male model, hit me up. Not for the map, just hit me up in general. Oh dear. Did have to bring that into videos, didn't I? What else do I want to talk about? Oh yeah, the reason I'm actually able to record at 9 o'clock in the morning as opposed to mid-afternoon. I've got coffee and I forgot about it. Still good. Still hot. The reason I'm recording so early, apart from the whole I didn't sleep last night thing, which is kind of about 50% of the reason, because my parents had to go up to my granddad. He's fine. As fine as he can be, I guess. He has dementia, so if you know somebody with dementia, you'll probably know this yourself. One of the big things with dementia that really, really, really gets to people, and especially, primarily families of dementia patients, is that, I guess the best way to do it is to kind of quickly explain dementia, / Alzheimer's, it's also known as Alzheimer's. Dementia is basically the brain starts deteriorating and connections within the brain start to deteriorate and the brain starts to misfire, resulting in short-term memory loss, almost complete short-term memory loss in most cases. occasionally selective short-term memory, where they'll remember just completely random things, and it's not, you know, the dementia patient being rude, it's that they genuinely only remember completely random things. But the big thing that I think the most famous thing that it causes, the thing that most people know, is the patient. You can tell I did a science degree based in medicine, can't you? The patient will tend to revert to a semi-childhood state. So they'll remember very vividly details about their childhood, and their long-term memory isn't affected whatsoever by it, in most cases. But one thing that does happen as a result of what is essentially just the brain misfiring horrifically and having one huge, massive, long brain fart is aggression. And it's down to... Well, there are different kinds of dementia as well, I guess, because some are based on imbalances in chemicals, and some are just plain the brain starts misfiring. But senile dementia, which is most common in old age, which my granddad does fall into old age, he is 79, 80. I don't know how old he is. He's old. He's beyond... He's well beyond... pension age. He's, I think, 79 or 80. He's 79 or 80, one of the two. He might be 81 at a long shot. But, the senile dementia tends to be the one where the brain just starts misfiring, you get the big, massive brain farts, no short-term memory, and, you know, it kind of screws over families because they get to know this, they kind of, oops. They have to suffer through the person they know essentially disappearing, and this new aggressive version of them suddenly appearing. And my granddad's been going through an aggressive period of late, so my parents have been up to keep an eye on him so that he doesn't try and escape the bloody nursing home again. He's only in a nursing home because he needs 24-hour care. And they've had to go up to give him 24-hour supervision, because all I'm going to say is the nursing home staff are not paid well enough to deal with him. When he gets aggressive, he is quite vicious and very rude. I've been going a bit over time. Oh well, I've got all the fertilizing done, which is nice. As you can see, the pigs and the beef are 90% productivity, which is awesome. I've got one pig and zero beefs ready to go. That's all the fertilizing done. I have no idea what I'm going to do in the next episode, because I didn't think that far ahead. That's me, isn't it? I just kind of, hey, we're going to do this, and next time we'll do the thing with the tractors and the farm. I will promise there will be a next episode. I just don't know what I'll be doing. I don't want to do more grass work. I'm kind of tired of grass work right now. I don't really want to fast forward into the harvest. I don't want to... there's not a whole lot I can do, is there? I guess the only real option open to me is to fast forward straight to the harvest and get working on that. I can't afford the Neva. If you watched me equipment spotlight yesterday, you'll know what I'm talking about. If not, your loss. Ooh, I can afford the Neva. I've just realised I can sell things. Do 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 do. This is the dumbest thing I'll do for a while, I think. But I'll do it in the next episode. Until then, stay safe and goodbye!